Yes. Good morning, my name is Vishal Sinha. I worked with Male for 6 years in India. I've been to Oringen, I've been to Stuttgart. So it really felt very proud to see Male's name on the board. And ma'am, I've worked in the technical line, and I now want to pursue some technical consultancy with German companies. But what work experience I have, I feel that anyone, the technological transfer is not that transparent and not that easy. So, because if anyone works and invests so much on research and development, they're not immediately transfer the services or the technological edge to someone who is coming from a different country or from a different region. That is but understood. But how can you support us if we want to work on a project which is a highly niche kind of project? And how are you able to, will you be able to connect me to the right person there and then initiate some kind of technological transfer or some details transfer, etc.? Will you be in a position to support us on that?
Yeah, we can try this once we have the requirements. This is difficult, but this hurdle we always have to overcome in each sector and in each business, right? And this we have to look on a case-to-case basis, but we can refer it back and work with our clusters, channels, and identify the companies who might be the right contact for you.
We need to inculcate a kind of confidence in both the parties so that the transfer is easy. So will you be able to bridge that gap? I hope that you extend your support in bridging that gap in case I come up with a specific requirement to you.
The intention of having an setup on both sides is to ensure that there's a trust built up on both sides. That is the key thing. Unless if a German company, we don't have a German thing on the other side, then it is difficult for them to believe in someone who's on the other side, and vice versa. And the whole reason of creating this platform is to ensure that we can bridge those gaps and make our SME segment and the SME segment in Germany come meet each other and start collaborating.
Right, Ashish. Thank you so much, Ashish.
Can I request you to please give all the details?
Let us
make a few success stories from today's meeting.
Sure.
Sir, you wanted to ask a question. Sorry, you interrupted twice.
Are you into IT collaboration also? My concern is that as your office is in Pune, if you are into IT collaboration, will you be interested in having someone in Nagpur for that thing?
Actually, what we do in the IT space is we help the German companies to find an Indian counterpart. So we work with Indian service providers, just a handful with certain technical skills, and then we help the Germans to come here and help to facilitate the cooperation, like on the soft skills level, like how to keep the deadlines, how to work with an Indian counterpart. On these lines, we support the cooperation. And also, when it comes to that Indian IT specialists have to travel to Germany, so we have clients that have sometimes whole teams on site in Germany on long-term basis as well as on short-term basis. So we help with all the work permits, with the visa issues, with finding for the long-term visas, the insurance, keep them as German employees, proper German employees, help them with immigration office, join them to go there, help them with lease agreements, finding flats, apartments, bringing family, and all these kind of how they integrate into the German work and life. So these kind of topics we support.
Yeah. So how shall a company go about on this?
An IT company?
Yeah, I do an IT company. And I do export to European countries, but like to see how I can do it for Germany.
Okay. Then
Let's connect offline.
The man for you.
I spent 12 years in Europe doing the same thing what you're talking about. Let's get in touch and figure out what exactly you're looking for, what is the niche that you believe is worth.
Sure,
and then we'll have a discussion.
Yeah, my question is in regard to the MOU which you said has been signed between the two chief ministers. I want to know the specifics in the MOU which encourage the business partnership between the state of BW and Maharashtra. So what are the specifics, or how is this billet for this growth is going to be provided under the MOU terms? Is there any guarantee that business of trade has to happen between the two states or something like that, or what is it like? I want to understand how that billet will be given to the business partnership between the two states.
So what the MOU says, it identifies sectors we want to work with, jointly, and this sector in ICT, in urban development, all the smart city topics are from renewable energies, tourism,
small and medium scale industry.
Yes, small and medium scale industry. These are the core sectors, but it doesn't define so many businesses have to come out of this.
And the whole point which we, as I mentioned as well, was, there's an MOU signed at a chief minister level. But signing of MOU and having a handshake every year does not guarantee it.
Exactly.
The whole reason why we are bringing up this collaboration platform and hence working closely with the state of Baden-Württemberg and representing them in India is to actually execute what is written in the at a very high level. Unless you work on the ground with people like VIA and the members of VIA, it will stay on the annual radar. Everyone will have a handshake meeting every year, and nothing will transpire. So the real work is to work with the end user, which in this case a specific industry, a specific unit, and try to build up a collaboration on the other side, whichever way it has to work.
Exactly, the roadmap can be like, Nagpur has been signed as a smart city. So there is German companies are interested. You can prepare a list of sectors which can actually have some kind of product available for the smart city project. In the same way, we'll have investors or we'll have some people of the same industry who are ready to partner that and get the technology and being manufactured in India and provide to the places like Nagpur and Pune, which are part of smart city. Like, this can be one example. So this is the kind of roadmap that we'll have to set together by VI and your organization led project together to work it and get some more investment in this region and partnerships actually collaborating for the such kind of project.
Ashish, that gives me an idea. Can we, as a matter of follow-up of this meeting, can we have a conference here in Nagpur where we at VI are ready to host it, wherein you bring some of the people those who actually know all about smart city. We also invite people of the local region and those to meet and have, you know, one-to-one talk on how to make our Nagpur a smart city. What are the possibilities?
Yeah,
Tejas
can answer that. We already tried.
Yeah, sorry. What are the possibilities and how soon this can be done?
I think this is a very good idea to start off. We would need to learn about your smart city concept.
Okay.
And we did very similarly now in January. We had a full day event on smart cities in Pune with German and Pune side, PMC from Pune. And actually we signed MOUs to develop smart township, and we got the first feasibility study already made jointly with Frau Hofer Institute on energy sources which should be used in a particular area. And I think this is a very good approach and would foster a cooperation. We can bring in the right people.
Yeah.
And then you start talking and seeing, you can show them what needs to be done, and then it becomes very alive and we can take it from there.
We
can have such a conference, I would say, sometime this year.
Can we also have, as you are having it at Pune, can we also hold one day conference here in Nagpur?
Yes.
Yeah.
Maybe all those people can only come to Nagpur and we also organize that.
Yes, yes. So, what we'll do is we'll decide the areas which Nagpur needs, And those areas have VI, we can decide on that.
Okay.
And we can identify some individuals and companies also are willing to work on those particular projects. And then we can have send that list to them. Then they can find out counterpart companies who would be willing. Then they can be called and meeting.
So that can be amazing, guys.
Yes.
I think we have VI and looking forward.
Very good start.
The Pune meeting was highly successful.
Yes.
The meeting, it was a full day session. So the arranged by Lethbridge was owning that entire session on behalf of the German government. And the response from the industry in Pune and the government, the PMC, it was very highly regarded. And we actually had the companies from Germany talking in that seminar and discussing one-to-one collaboration opportunities with the local companies in the region to develop the smart city concept on various areas, right from traffic mobility all the way to the other side of the segment. On that, so as you said, yeah, we can definitely work with you on that. Just identify certain specific areas, companies in from Nagpur side which might be of interest, and we can then start collaborating on the other side and see something happening in here sometime this year. Earlier the better.
And actually, what also helped a lot and impressed the German colleagues, there are like 45 from the smart city sector on the German side, and they saw projects which are conducted in Pune at the moment. For instance, the traffic control center, which has been started with new software and whatsoever. So they were very impressed also to see what is going on in the city. And this could be also something which can be organized in the frame of such a conference that you show your city and what's going already there for the smart city and what kind of project pilots you plan or what kind of projects you have in the pipeline. And this is the perfect starting point because it's very alive, it's not theoretically.
No, we want to do it practically.
Yeah.
Prashant, is it possible, we have a committee here who is planning for smart city Nagpur. Is it possible to arrange a meeting with these two, with them? So, is it possible?
I think we'll have
so
to
then they know what all is happening
PMC,
and at what stage the...
I think we'll have to talk to PMC regarding this initiatives are driven by PMC. I think we are all part of one of the initiatives there. So I think definitely we can explore this.
Sure, we'll be happy to work with you on any of these areas. We have already experience in the smart city related work in Pune.
Sure. Absolutely. We extend your invitation.
We'll take a last question.
Some more questions, please.
In the presentation, I saw something about education, and I work in the early childhood education sector in Nagpur. So we are always looking for new pedagogies all over the world to deal with kids, because that is really a very sensitive and very important area to work with. So is there any scope wherein we can have something to do with the early childhood education in India?
Early childhood means from
up to 6 years.
Okay.
Till they start formal education from the grade one.
Yeah.
So like could be daycare, could be the kindergarten, could be
They have several concepts, and I think we can link you to these that can find out what are your requirements and what can be done and where you can create the synergies or have an exchange.
Yeah, even some of the universities who could give, who are always doing R&Ds in early childhood. So even some of the universities who can give me information about the small distance courses or, short term courses kind of it.
Yeah.
So that could also be helpful.
Yeah. Can you get in touch with us and also give us the requirements and what specifically you are looking for? Because we have specific universities where we train the people for pedagogy, the early childhood education. And one has to interlink it with those kind of institutions.
May take one or two more questions, please. Yeah, please.
I would like to know state specific for a sector into you have environment and sustainability. My company is into waste management, waste to energy projects. So do you have such sectors open for collaboration in Germany? because for technology advancement, we are taking, we are already buying some products from Germans, and we are installing it in India, and we are doing large-scale products with projects with Haldia, PepsiCo, Coca-Cola. So if such kind of collaboration, if we can do in Germany also such projects, because all what we are talking about is for manufacturing companies who can do some collaboration, but what for the engineering project companies? Do you have any case-specific projects or sectors in which we can go for waste-to-energy projects?
I think this is a very up-to-date topic, and we have to explore it in detail, but it's also a big topic in Germany, actually, and we should look into it.
Where because Nagpur is also a hub of these environmental consultants, and the National Environmental Engineering Institute itself is in Nagpur.
Yeah, he showed me. Yeah, Impressive Institute. We were driving by just the morning. Yeah.
Can I get in touch with you for this?
Definitely. Yeah.
Well, we can take one last question if anybody can. Okay. One last question from me, Matthias. You said there are a lot of ideas being generated by people there, and that's how they are innovative. What is that environment or ecosystem which makes them do that?
In Germany, you mean? How
do they do so? What's the kind of an environment that we also would like to better fit the region of the
Netherlands? Actually, what I've found is they encourage young people or their employees already in doing kind of concepts to bring in their ideas. They create a company culture where their own employees are asked to improve their environment, to improve the technology, and they are invited to present their ideas, and not only their ideas, but also present solutions. And this kind of atmosphere in a company encourages the people to start thinking of new solutions or improvements in their personal environment. And this can be done at university level, like companies can do like a process for young students to bring in ideas, and but not only ideas to improve the environment, for instance, but also bring in solutions. And then one can create startups out of these young people. So one can do a lot, because this creates an environment, an atmosphere of encouragement to think about solutions for everyday problems. And this is what's done by a lot of entrepreneurs in Germany on their own little campus, or on their little factory. And I think this is a concept what can be transferred also.
Okay, that's great. We'll be glad to note that we have already done that. We have already floated a knowledge fest with all the academic institutions. And to our surprise, we could get 110 entries online. So now we'll be having 110 projects which are being made by them and will be presented to PI. We already have made juries from industry. We'll be entering them, and we're also rewarding them also. So that has already begun.
Yeah.
Okay.
And out of the best brains, you can recruit the best people, no? It's also in the spirit.
Okay. Thank you so much.
So how can we get in touch with Ashish and Ms. Baker?
We'll give you our cards to you as once we finish off this session. And then we can exchange and get in touch.
They'll be here. After this, there's a press conference, and then they'll be available here.
Okay.
From 1 to 2, we are also holding a conference with the academics of the colleges of the region, institutions, and with them. After that, they will be available. If you want, you can meet them. But one very, very special request to all of you, those who want to do anything, just give them everything in writing and mark a copy to VIA, so that it will be easier. And then once you are after them, it will be easier for us to call them again, to follow up and see that we create success stories. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ashish ji, for sharing the wisdom with us. Definitely our president is not here, but I can like to assure that maybe I can act as an helpdesk for your initiative in Nagpur, and we'll be looking for some collaboration, deep collaboration with you in future. I request our Vice President Prashant Bhutaji to give a moment of token to Ari. There's more compliments from us. And I request Ayushman to bring your CM next time to Nagpur, because our senior CM is also from Nagpur, so we can have a good collaboration in the conference. And I think you are from the south of Germany, and you missed on good vineyards, good wine and beer. It's also very good from that region. I think you missed on it. Thank you very much, and thank you very much.
Let's talk about it.